All right, everyone. So this is going to be a little quickie video. I stumbled across another eBay find and I wanted to share it in case you might be looking for something on the line of what I was looking for, which was I kind of stumbled across a good switch box that had an e-stop on it and a standard normally open switch. And this was, I thought, was a really good deal. It's a good quality brand. It's from, I guess you pronounce that Beko, I'm not sure. Don't slam me for it, but it's a switch box, and let me get a screwdriver real quick. And I'll open this up for you because I had forgotten that I had closed it. But really nice enclosure. It's got a knockout on the top and a knockout on the bottom, so you can run your wire in or out. It's got an e-stop, which I've never seen one shaped like that. And this is a twist to reset e-stop, which means that when you push it, it stays pressed in and it will not release until you give it a slight clockwise turn. I prefer these e-stops over the push-pull type. It just seems to me like it's a little bit more, you want it to be inconvenient. When you deactivate an e-stop, you want to do it intentionally. And you know, some of the big mushroom head e-stops, you technically could actually snag that on something. It could be your clothes, it could be a piece of material you're moving around. This is just a little bit more intentional. So on the inside of here, let me just kind of zoom you in. I'll come this way and we'll try to do it right here. All right, so this is the front, and you've got just a standard push button here. This is a normally open, which means the contact isn't made until you press it down. The e-stop is actually a normally closed, so it's passing current, or it's passing continuity between its two contacts until you press it in and you hear it click. And to reset it, you give it a slight turn and it'll pop back out. So it's a pretty small box. This is like 4 inches by, let's say, 2.5, 3. And the back of the switch is right there. Now inside this is the contactor blocks. And like I said, you've got the red one. This red indicates that this is a normally closed switch. So when you press it, it actually breaks the contacts between these two screws. Now the green one is just the opposite. It's normally open. So when you press it, it's now common between the two screws. And so those made up on the inside of the box like this. And this is a kind of neat, interesting box. Again, it's got a knockout on the top, if you can see that in the glare right there, and a knockout on the bottom. And the legend plate on the front says stop and override. So you could actually use this as a cycle start button as well. And then you have an e-stop that could be mounted on the machine or mounted on the enclosure. And it's good quality stuff. I ended up picking this up for 20 bucks or so. And it looks like the person that's selling them now changed their price to 20 bucks. So I think that's a really good deal. These two switches alone would cost more than that. And plus you get the box. And it's got this nice weatherproofing on the inside, this gasket that goes all the way around, and some pretty beefy screws. So just wanted to share that. I'm not sure how many they have of these, but they do have more. So I just wanted to pass that on. So check it out. Link will be in the description below. And as always, we'll talk to you next time.